Stephen Gately from Dublin's inner city had found international stardom as part of the pop act Boyzone. But in 1999, the British Sun newspaper received a tip-off that Stephen was gay. He took the brave option to out himself. It created a media frenzy.
I remember seeing him sitting at the side of the stage before they were going on, and he kind of was by himself, and he kind of was a little bit kind of head down in his hands and stuff like that. I mean, he was clearly nervous about it because it had never been done before.
He was the first boy in a boy band to actually come out and say, I'm gay.
The band braced themselves for a possible backlash.
In relation to Stephen Gately, you know, having been forced to come out with his story, I really think he personally should be commended for the dignified and intelligent way he actually handled it.
Once he came out, he was swamped with love, love bombed.
I started getting thousands upon thousands of letters, emails, faxes of support that was just unbelievable. And I start reading, and when I start going through the letters, I seen that there was letters from teenagers who were gay themselves who said, you know, you've given me so much hope. I actually got a couple of letters saying, you know, I was gonna commit suicide. You've given me so much hope. You've changed my mind with kids. And that to me actually meant more.
It was the best thing in his life because he was free. He'd nothing to hide from. And everybody loved him for it. Nobody cared when it did happen. Absolutely. And I think he led the way for an awful lot of other gay pop stars to come out.
This is Mark. Hello.
Stephen's actions made it possible for other boy band stars to be free to live their lives their way.
I wasn't anywhere near as nervous when it happened to me because he started the ball rolling, you know. I wasn't with my head in my hands. I wasn't kind of, you know, sort of really kind of apprehensive and stuff like that, you know. I was actually the total opposite.
By 2000, the Boyzone dream was coming to an end. The band was beginning to fragment. Ronan was anxious to pursue a solo career, and Stephen also launched a solo venture. The band took a one-year sabbatical. 1 year became seven. The dream was over. The once close-knit Boyzone family went their separate ways.
I think when Boyzone broke up, it definitely affected Stephen because he didn't have the support and the fun and the friendship of the other four boys around him.
If I believe that I can do anything, can I spread my wings and say goodbye?
Suddenly, the Boyzone carpet was whipped out from under him, and it wasn't there. That magic carpet wasn't there anymore. He came crashing to the ground.
Look at me now. Here I am in sky.
I was depressed for 2 years.
Were you?
Yeah, it was really weird. I just became a hermit. I had a solo album, but my heart and soul wasn't into it. I didn't do any promotion. I just didn't want to be there.
Luckily, there were very good people around. People who were able to offer him support and say, you know, think of what else you can do with your life.
In Dublin, Caroline Downey was looking for a co-presenter for the Childline charity concert.
Louis and I were talking about it, and he said, Stephen would love to do it, would you have him? And sure, he was perfect. Boyzone had headlined it the year before, so he was ideal.
We love Stephen, don't we? I feel I'm on top of the world!
It was amazing to watch him. I mean, Stephen, if he had doubts, I never really saw the doubts, because he just had this ability just to dust himself off and go forward and go and do what he wants. And I think Louis was really, really supportive, encouraged him that he could do whatever he wanted to do.
Disappointed with limited success on the recording front, Stephen was released from a solo recording contract in the summer of 2001. He turned to his boyhood love of the stage for inspiration.
Put on your Sunday clothes, there's lots of world out there. Get out the brilliant teen and dime cigar.
His accent was very Dublin, and if he wanted to go forward and go into the West End, he had to lose the strong Dublin accent. So he went and did elocution lessons, and he did all the things that could adapt him to the West End.
He auditioned and won a part in Andrew Lloyd Webber's production of Joseph. Stephen then won the role of the child catcher in the hugely successful West End run of Chitty Chitty Bang Bang.
I remember when I was doing Child Catcher in Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, and Stephen, I think he was about two actors in after me, and I met him in Ballins in the West End, and we were talking about it. And I said to him, you should be like a little spider scuttle about. He took it very, very seriously, as he did all his West End jobs.
Lollipops, children.
You wouldn't think it, Stephen Gately is the child catcher. And he didn't play it for laughs, like a lot of people would have. He did it straight, which is hard to do, you know, being in a jolly, jolly show and everybody wants to be liked. He didn't.
Carving out a new life for himself, Stephen settled in the London village of Highgate. He formed a new family of close friends, one of whom was local Patricia Robertson. Stephen affectionately called her Pat the Baker.
I met him on a Sunday, and I said, would you like to come for Sunday lunch the next Sunday? And he said, oh yes. The following Sunday, he was in my kitchen peeling potatoes for Sunday lunch. He was down to earth, friendly. You would not think he mixed with celebrities at all.
Another close friend was Phyllis Harper, who owns the local Highgate butcher shop.
Well, he used to come in and say, hi, and walk round here and normally make a beeline for this seat. He would sit down, and if I was busy, if the phone would go, he would answer the phone for me, Highgate Butchers. A lot of people thought it might be like I was a surrogate mother to him, but it wasn't like that at all. It was just, we just connected. We were like soulmates. We had the same sense of humour, the same sense of fun, and we just lived, loved and laughed. It was wonderful. Stephen loved Highgate very much because people didn't worry him here. They just let him live his life, so he felt comfortable with that.
Stephen found happiness with his new partner, Andrew Cowles.
How did the two of you meet?
We met through mutual friends at a party a few times, and then they kind of match made us. They told me to call Stephen, Stephen called me. And
when the law was changed in Britain, Andrew and Stephen married in 2006.
They took us out to dinner and they said, we have something to ask you. And we said, what? And they said, would you be our witnesses at the wedding? And Phyllis and I looked at each other. We were astonished. We couldn't believe it.
We were so honoured to think that we were such good friends that they wanted us there.
He was totally in command with his sexuality, and he knew exactly, you know, he had Andy as his partner. Everybody knew them. They were always out together. They had the same wedding rings. They did everything together. And I think, you know, it was a total entity that he created in London for his lifestyle. No matter what
they tell us. Despite the happiness Stephen had found in his private life, his one wish was to see Boyzone reform.
See, that gets me going now. I think we've definitely got to have a Boyzone reunion. Just, does anyone else agree? Watching that makes you want to see Boyzone get back on that stage and do it again. Is it going to happen?
I don't know.
In 2007, this wish was to be granted as the boys put aside their differences and talk of a reunion suddenly became a reality.
The Boyzone reunion, it could only come from the five boys. They all had to want it, and they all wanted it.
Now, there was I thinking you couldn't stand the sight of each other.
Oh, no. What was it like getting up there just then and doing that? Was it quite
it was
a weird
incredible,
thing?
I loved it.
Oh,
it was
so good.
Everybody loved it.
Show that we're going to do, we're going to have to do something spectacular. It has to be so well done. So we're really going to put all our creative ideas together.
Boyzone obviously was what actually made him famous. So I think he was really thrilled to be going back into that and to have that success all over again.